Thank you and welcome to our gathering, our vigil, in memory of those who died in Christchurch in New Zealand a week ago. I'm sure you know Christchurch New Zealand was named for Christchurch here in Oxford, so we thought it was fitting to remember the atrocities there in this place a week on.
Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil anbiya wal mursaleen. My dear brothers, sisters and friends, I greet you with Islamic greeting of peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. May peace and blessing of Almighty God be upon you all. Thank you for coming and gathering and supporting the Muslims. You know what is happening, of course, in the New Zealand. I would like to perform in honor of our deceased 50 people who get killed, and of course, in solidarity with their friends and families, I would like to read the call to prayer, which we done yesterday in the Trafalgar Square with the thousands of people. And of course, they came like us together to show the solidarity. And of course, after that, read some prayer for the deceased and the peace from the book. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله عيل سلام حيّل الفلاح حيّ على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. All praise are due to Allah. We praise Him, seek His help, and ask for His forgiveness. We seek refuge in the Lord for the evil of our deeds, our own selves, and for the evil of our deeds. Whomsoever the Lord Allah guides, no one can lead astray, and whomsoever he lead astray, no one can guide. I bear witness that none has the right to worship but him, and I bear witness that Muhammad is his last messenger. O dear Lord, we ask you to bless us in this world, and to bless us in the life after, and grant us your salvation from the torment and punishment. O Lord, we ask you to receive our deceased, the 50 innocent worshippers, worshiper, men and women, young and old, who their lives overtaken and robbed by a terrorist when they were praying at your house, the mosque. They were killed in a most cruel and barbaric way. We ask you, O Lord, to receive them with your full mercy and compassion, and place them and honor them in your paradise. Dear Lord, we ask you to help their families and friends in this time of the sorrow and grief. O Allah, make it easy for them to bear the pain of sudden loss of beloved mother, father, sons, daughters, sisters, brothers, and friends. We ask you, dear Lord, to ease their pains and make it easy for them to cope, and grant them happiness and long life. Beside of these, O dear Lord, we ask you to open the hearts of all we meet, so we may convey the message of peace in our homes, in our families, in our neighborhoods, in our cities, countries, and across the world. Restore in us our faith in you, O Lord, our faith in unity, our faith in humanity, our faith in friends and families, and our faith in each other. May our efforts be sincere and fruitful, and may our commitment to peace bring other friends and families into this fold, so they may to experience the beauty of being at peace. O dear Allah, O dear Lord, please grant us our wishes. Amen.
He honore, he gloria, he hallelujah kia iroa. Nāna nei ngā mea katoa me te whakamutunga. Te mea tuatahi māku he mihi tēnei ki te atua. Te mea tuarua māku he mihi kia rātou mā kua whiturangi tia. Moe mai, moe mai, moe mai. Kia tātou te hunga ora, nei kā mihi kia koutou katoa i tēnei wā. He mihi poto tēnei kia koutou, kia whakahono, kia rātou kei te kainga, kia tū kotahi ai tātou katoa. Kia ora everyone, I'm Evie O'Brien, and it's my humble honour to greet you in the native Indigenous language of New Zealand. With a purpose to join us in thought, in prayer, in love, and in solidarity with those in New Zealand, those families who are mourning, and all New Zealanders and all of the world here as well.
Assalamu alaikum. Peace be upon you. The violent assault last Friday against Muslims praying in their mosques has shocked New Zealanders and people all over the world. Today, we gather to remember those who lost their lives, those who were injured, their families and loved ones. We do not grieve alone. The support and love shown by those around New Zealand and around the world has been amazing and humbling to witness. At this time of sorrow, at a time when we can be tempted to despair, we gather together to celebrate the strong bonds of community and the outpouring of love, compassion, and kindness over this past week. And we come to hope that this may be the narrative that will win out over that of hatred and death.
From New Zealand's High Commissioner to London, Sir Jerry Mataparai. The attack on our Muslim brothers, sisters, and children at worship within the sanctuary of their mosque was an utterly callous and cowardly act of terrorism. Our Muslim communities are our family. They are our friends, our colleagues, our neighbours. They are us. The terrorist attack in Christchurch was an assault against our core values, but it cannot shake our values. In New Zealand, we believe that diversity is a strength, something we celebrate. We have no tolerance for violence and extremism of any kind, and we utterly reject the ideology behind it. In a country that practices religious tolerance, an attack on one of us is an attack on all of us.
The thought of my affliction and my homelessness is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it and is bowed down within me. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. The Lord is good to those who wait for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good that one should wait quietly for the salvation of the Lord. It is good for one to bear the yoke in youth, to sit alone in silence when the Lord has imposed it, to put one's mouth to the dust, there may yet be hope, to give one's cheek to the smiter and be filled with insults. For the Lord will not reject forever. Although he causes grief, he will have compassion according to the abundance of his steadfast love. For he does not willingly afflict or grieve anyone.
Today, I'm laying these flowers in memory of those who lost their lives in Christchurch, New Zealand. And I do so on behalf of all the citizens of Oxford. This laying of flowers, when it happens, has been happening at vigils across New Zealand and in many cities all over the world. These flowers will remain at the vigil site for a time, and after which they will be cast into the River Thames. This is a practice common to memorials in New Zealand, and we will be doing the same here. Thank you.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Right now I can think of hundreds of verses from the Noble Quran that would be appropriate to our gathering here today, but I'm not going to do that. I will suffice with what I have just recited before you. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Almost every chapter of the Noble Quran begins with this particular verse and with this statement. And it means, I begin in the name of God, the Merciful, the Compassionate. Of the 99 names of God in Islam, these two names repeat themselves more than any other name. Ar-Rahman meaning merciful, Rahim meaning compassionate. You see, mercy and compassion are natural. Hate is fed into people. Mercy, peace, love, harmony, cooperation, all these things, they are natural. Anything that goes against them is not natural. It will break communities apart. Hate cannot drive out hate, just like darkness will not drive out darkness. Darkness can only be overcome with light. Hate can only be overcome with love. And Islam is based upon love. Religions generally are all based upon love. We appreciate the people of New Zealand, specifically the Prime Minister. They have outdone themselves in looking at terror in the eyes and saying to it, you will not divide us, you will not defeat us. Terrorism has only one objective, and that is to divide people, to create conflict, disharmony, war, hate. Yet this particular incident has backfired on the terrorists. It has united not only New Zealand, a tiny country of just 4 million, but rather it has united faiths and people all over the world. The people of New Zealand should be proud of themselves. They have taught the world many, many precious lessons. Mercy and compassion is one of the traits that the people of New Zealand have very much expressed, especially of the last week. So much has been going on, yet the people of New Zealand have grown stronger and stronger and stronger, and we as humanity are proud of them. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of God, the merciful, the compassionate, I'd like to end with the Fatiha, which is the very first chapter in the Noble Quran, and it is, you could say, an equivalent of the Lord's Prayer in Christian faith. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm Al-Din, Iyaka Na'budu Wa Iyaka Nasta'een, Idina Sirat Al-Mustaqeem, Sirat Al-Ladhina An'amta Alayhim, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. May we all remain united for the good, for the welfare of each other, and keep looking out for each other, regardless of which community we belong to, regardless of which color, creed, or which religion we come from or we belong to. We should all remain united all the time in the face of adversity, in the face of hate, and make sure terrorism, as it has backfired recently, it continues to backfire until it is completely defeated. Thank you very much.
Heal their bodies and hearts. Console them with your presence and at the same time take away any hatred and desire for revenge. We pray that you would draw near and comfort the families and friends of those who have lost their lives. Enable them in your mercy to seek refuge in you as they grieve. We pray for the police, first responders, medical personnel, and intelligence services, and for all those who work to prevent future attacks. We pray for our governments, that you would inspire them to govern with wisdom and determination. We pray for the Muslim community in New Zealand, the UK, Oxford, and throughout the world, that you would protect them from unjust aggression and discrimination. We pray for ourselves that as we stand together in solidarity, we would commit ourselves to lives of peace. And finally, Lord, we pray that you would touch the hearts of those who commit acts of terror, that they may recognize the evil of their actions and may turn to the way of peace and goodness, of respect for the life and dignity of every human being. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Lord God, you hold both heaven and earth in a single piece. Let the design of your great love shine on the waste of our anger and sorrow, and give peace to your people, peace among the nations, peace in our homes, peace in our hearts. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.